I told you that I was going to start a YouTube channel at 70 years old? And you said, what? Are you crazy, lady? Well, join me as I tell you about my first year on YouTube and what my experience has been. So, anyway, I had quite a task, you know, again, trying to figure, okay, what are they going to, what am I good at? What is everyone doing on YouTube? Following some of the, like I said, the estheticians I was following, I knew what they were doing, and they were reviewing products, and they had big, big warehouses full of product. And so basically that's what they were doing, is just selling things through their warehouse. Well, I thought, I don't have a warehouse. So how am I going to, what do I have to offer? Well, I had 40 years of experience doing this. 40 years of experience of working on people's skin and knowing what's going on. And I am one of those people that, you know, if you say to me, well, this works, you better show it to me, because I'm going to investigate it. I'm going to go to the white paper on it. I'm going to do my own case studies. I want to know that it works, because first of all, I have to have my own face that looks half decent to get more clients, because like so many baby boomers today, and that's a big target of my audience, is we're still working. And we're going through life because we don't feel old. You know, we're just getting the best of what we do. And that's how I felt. I have so much to offer new estheticians and people that are following YouTube, and they're just almost a victim of marketing. They have so much product in their bathroom and nothing works because they're just, it's a commercial. It's a big, huge commercial. And I thought, I've got to show these people what works and what doesn't work. And the other thing too is working with mature makeup. Most of the people that you see on YouTube say they're mature at 40, 45, or maybe they're 50. Well, let's put that makeup on somebody my age or older. And that's what I work with. I have clients that I've redone their makeup. You know, I do it yearly to update them, that are 90 some years old. So you have to have products that are working for that age. So it has taken me a year to kind of identify what my audience. I mean, I'm a little over 100 subscribers. I'm still very small, but I'm very enthusiastic. What they're looking for and what they're following of some of the videos that I've produced. Unfortunately, the one that where I actually show some of my before and afters of clients that I have worked on got the least views. What they really like are my Jane Iredale and some of my other cosmetic lines that I sell in my studio. And so that's encouraging too, because it keeps me up in the air on what I'm going to do. But I think the whole thing is what, and I'm saying I got involved in this too, is that people will say, you know, this primer, this stem cell, this moisturizer, collagen moisturizer, is so good. It's so good. And so what do? Is we go to their affiliate link and we buy it. And we use it for 2 weeks and it doesn't work. Well, first of all, you've got to use a product 3 to 4 months before you know it works. We didn't get this way, you know, in the last day and a half. We've got to really give it a try, but know what you're using and know the background and the white paper and, you know, is this a product that is sold over the counter at CVS or at Sephora? What is there? Yes, there's going to be marketing there. that has a lot to do with it. And that's why all the people on YouTube do so well, and I admire them. I wish I was back years before all this started. But that's not where I want to come from. I want to show you why a product works, how it's getting into your skin, because remember, our skin is the largest organ of our body, and it's meant to keep things out. So we have a microbiome on our skin, just like we do our stomach. It's meant to keep things out. But how's this stuff getting in? So this special $250 collagen cream, what is it going to do? It's not going anywhere. It can't get through the first 15 layers. It can't get through the first 14 layers because the molecule's too big. And, you know, these are the things that people, they don't understand. They haven't been in the business long enough to see how this has generated forward. You know, back when I first started, we did one facial, and that was like a European facial. And we didn't have magic things. We did the same thing on everybody. And then the 80s came. And then what we do is we burn their face every month when they come in. So that's when the glycolic acids and the salicylic and the Jesners and the TCIs or TC, whatever they are, they came in. So we just burned the skin because they're gonna just take all the dead layers off. Well, those dead layers are there to protect the skin and not let anything in. And I always say this, if you followed me, you know, the epidermis is grapes, raisins, and cornflakes. And that's just, they're all in the process of dying and moving upward. And that's the circle of life. Our whole body's that way. And so how do we think that moisturizer is going to get down into our dermis and change the DNA of our cells? Really? So I just felt that I thought, you know, I've got so much experience in working with these companies, doing their case studies and seeing the results in my own clientele. And at 71 years old, I have the best business that I've ever had in all my years in this business. And it's because I understand how to change things. And the biggest thing that I see when I have my clients come in, and again, it's marketing, and that's what just makes things all, you know, buzz. I mean, that's what it's all about, is they have so much stuff. I make them bring it in. I want to know what their routine is. I want to know what they're using, why they're using it, what's comfortable, what have they liked. My God, they might as well haul in a wagon. The stuff that they're buying, and again, even on TV, you know, the cantaloupe that's going to change your life. It's crazy. How's it getting there? That's what you need to know. What is the science behind it? Can you change the DNA of your skin? And I'm telling you, you can. And that's through 40 years. And not 10 years. 10 years, we didn't, you know, 10 years. And not using it for 2 weeks and saying, oh, this is the best there is. And I had to learn this because I was a victim. I got caught up in that marketing. And I started buying this and buying this, especially with makeup. And I thought, wait a second, I'm a professional. I've done this for 40 years. And I've sold it in my studio and my salons. I've had 8 of them. I've sold it throughout the years. I've worked with women going through the aging process. I understand that. So I thought, wait a second, I'm barking up the wrong tree. I've got an audience out there, and I've got an audience that's authentic. And I know I've said I'm for authenticity. I'm not going to fill my face with fillers. I'm not going to Botox myself where you can't. See, I have lines, but I have other ways to fix them. Maybe not as instant as Botox, but we've got some technology out there that is just phenomenal. And so that has encouraged me to stay in this business. And like I said, I'm doing better than ever, and I'm fixing faces. I'm fixing faces, mature makeup, baby boomers, glycation, elastosis, rosacea. It makes me crazy because the other thing that I don't is I'm holistic. I'm Chinese medicine trained. So I always treat the inside of the body because our outer side, our skin, is absolute telltale what's going on inside your body. And that has been, we go back 10,000 years on this. And I have trained with some of the most fabulous people, Dr. Ben Johnson, and holistic practitioner. And I've taken their course, and I'll put their link. I don't have their names right off, because remember, I'm 71. But, you know, I've learned things, and just in the last, I'm going to say 7 to 10 years, I've been able to correct things that even your dermatologist couldn't, because they were treating the symptoms. They were treating allopathically, not treating the cause of what's going on. And it makes me so crazy to watch these makeup videos. And, you know, they're beautiful. These women that are doing these are absolutely beautiful. And I wish I looked like that, but I don't. But, you know, I still look like this, and I can make it the best that I can be. But what I was going to say, they say, well, use this to cover up your rosacea. You know, you got to buy this because this is going to cover up your rosacea. What's the optimum word there? Cover up. Let's fix it. That's a microbiome disorder. And even if you go to your dermatologist, they're going to tell you, you know, we can't fix this. You're going to have it the rest of your life. Well, yes, you can. Maybe it's going to flare up at different times by what you're eating. But it has to do with your gut and your microbiome. And all of us today, our acne, our eczema, our autoimmune diseases are all caused by our foods, pathogens, pesticides, everything that has come in that is just destroying us. But it's oh, this is probably going to get me in trouble, but it makes us have to buy prescriptions. Isn't that the truth? Well, I just, it makes me crazy. So when I say cover your rosacea, let me fix it. And I can fix it on the telephone for you. I can tell you what to do. It's, and I've had so many success stories on it. So it's been quite a learning because, okay, what am I going to, what sees and what doesn't sees, what gets views, what gets comments. And from what I've learned, that's what makes your channel, according to YouTube, it makes it more, so it comes up more often. And again, I'm way at the bottom of the list right now, but I'm growing fast. And so I'm trying to pay attention to what people are saying to me, what they want to see, and, you know, the different type of makeup looks. And I've had so much fun just experimenting with all my different videos. So it's a game, and I've had to learn that game. And at times I thought, you know, I have no business being on here. But I do, because I have the experience. I've been doing this for so long. I have seen the transition go forward in, not, like I said, not only our technology, but in our social media. And I want, I think it's for the future estheticians, for them to really figure out what's going on. I would say at this point, I'm one of the few holistic estheticians here in Northern Nevada. And I, you know, it's the movement. It's, you can see that in everything, in the people you follow, on YouTube, the doctors, the functional medicine doctors, and the green movement. Again, we've got, the United States has more toxic chemicals and pesticides than any country in the world. We have over 1,500, Canada with 5. And our government's not going to change that. And to look at something and not recognize the wording of what's in a product or the white paper that they have done with more holistic, the studies that they do are on real people. But they're not going to get any backing from the FDA because you can't make it a prescription. So you don't get to see those, and sometimes they just disappear. So, you know, I think we all need to understand that. We see a really a good, clean movement in our cosmetics and so forth going forward. And like I said, I quit using chemicals and stuff a long time ago. But again, there's a lot of words out there that have been invented that actually mean something else. So you got to kind of be a scientist about words. And like I said, when people bring their stuff into me, they have so many brands, so many serums, so many creams that I thought, you know, how do you expect anything to work? And it really became apparent to me when we started getting more into the bioactive ingredients. And what I'm saying bioactive is medical grade that is actually reaching and changing your DNA in your body. You can't go to CVS and buy one of those. Of course, the technology there is very expensive. You've got to understand what you're putting. You can't just say, okay, I'm going to put a stem cell on my face. Well, you can't do that. Stem cells in any cell in your body can become a stem cell, a human stem cell. You put a plant stem cell in there and it can't. Yes, the plant stem cells, we were introduced to those, oh God, 30 years ago, the apple, I can't remember all what it was. But yes, they're great for hydration and the peptides and stuff, but they're not going to change your DNA. You need a signaling molecule, and that's what I have with Neogenesis, that's actually going to signal the cells in the body. I'm going to do another video on growth factors and stem factors and stuff. When I have more time, because it's going to take more time, and how they're so important today, and the way they get into the body, the liposome delivery, the certain things that help deliver that to change the DNA. So it's exciting. It's exciting. But I've seen this through my experience, is they will have so many different peptides and growth factors and stem factors and serums and vitamin A's, vitamin C's, and just everything. But they're stacking them all on top of each other. So usually they're not working because they, you know, if science wanted to have your stem factor or your stem factor mixed with the vitamin C or your vitamin A, it put it together. Well, they're not meant. They have different delivery systems. They have different jobs in your skin. So piling them on top of each other is not working. It's a waste of money. You've got to have a different system. So I think that's one of the biggest things that I see when my clients bring their problem. You know, I know, okay, are you working on your elastosis? Are you working on glycation or pigmentation? Pigmentation has been, it has been my nemesis for all these years. And we're just now getting closer and closer to having and correcting some of that pigmentation. But again, our skin is smarter than we are. And, you know, it has a purpose. It has a purpose to, I'm petting my dog here. She thinks her name's Mary Lucy. She thinks she should be in here with us. because I'm in her room. I just thought I would come in and this is kind of explained. These are the things that I've learned through, all the ones that I follow and where I fit. And I'm really coming, I've tried to mimic some of the other ideas of the YouTube followers. It doesn't work. The only thing that's going to work for me is my experience. And hopefully out there, I'll get some followers that can see what I can do and you know, you might live a long ways from me but give you more education on what you're buying. The stuff out there is very, very expensive. And like me, I wished I had all the money that I've spent in the last 2 years on makeup and other lines of skincare, trying to figure out what they knew, what I didn't. Isn't that crazy? And so, yes, I might be 71 years old, but I have a lot to offer. And the biggest population right now is our baby boomers, and they want to look good. They don't want to look like our grandmothers before our great grandmothers. We have a different look. We have a different spirit. I'm excited because I know there's an audience for me out there. I know it. And so if you like this video, this is my year anniversary. Please give me a comment and let me know what you're interested in. Give me some ideas on what is so confusing for you when you go to the drugstore, when you go to Sephora or Ulta or to your esthetician. Is she doing the right kind of treatments on you? If she's burning your face every month, you need to find another esthetician. Glycolic peels and, you know, it's a big, big money maker with the derms and the plastic surgeons. That'll never go away because they convince you if you start having Botox at 25, it's going to stop your aging. Well, that's not true. And I've seen it. And I've seen through acceleration of atrophying that muscle, how much more wrinkles you get as you age. It's almost like a Sharpay. And I mean, this muscle here connects back here. So instead of our eyes falling, it's our forehead that's coming down. So the more we're atrophying that muscle, and some of you might not agree with me, but I've seen it and I've had experience with myself. I don't know if you ever watched it, but I saw a couple of my videos and I thought, oh, girlfriend, you look awful. So my girlfriend, she had been doing Botox for 20 years. She convinced me to go in and have it. Well, so she put, you know, all this in here. Well, I was one of the lucky ones that it traveled and it took my eyelid clear down. I looked like I had Bell's palsy and I was like that. She tried to fix it and it didn't work. I looked horrible for 3 months. And I go to the eye doctor because in my left eye, I have macular. And thank God that I went into a trial program 3 years ago and it's kind of held it at bay. But in order to see the eye, he had to put in like a little brace that they put in your eye to hold it open because the eye wouldn't move. Oh God, I was so embarrassed. But it makes me nervous because I know it travels. I know it goes into the brainstem and I've seen the results of it. And again, with fillers, they can do a lot of work. I mean, they can, with Sculpla and some of the other ones, they could really improve it. But then you can also look like you've been on prednisone for 4 months. Also, it takes that authentic V-line. Yes, I have a V-line. It may have little dits here and there. But you know, the authentic way that you look at yourself and how we progress. There's nothing wrong with a few wrinkles. Every wrinkle is caused by an emotion. What do I usually say? I say it in my holistic. It's an emotional And you can read. Chinese have been doing this for 10 years. You can read what's going on, and that's what I do in a child, in a person's face, on what's going on in their life by the shape of the mouth, the shape of the nose, the color of the nose, what's happening in the eyes. And I can kind of read the different sections of the face, of where they're breaking out or where they're having their disorders on their face or their diseases. And I can tell what's going on inside their body and what needs to be corrected. So, you know, this was a kind of a chit chat, and, you know, typical me, I jump from one subject to the other and don't finish all my sentences, but I want you to leave some comments and what you would like to see me address and talk about, what happens when you go to a store, what decisions you have to make when you choose what's best for you. And if you've got sensitive skin, join the 90% of people out there that have sensitive skin, because their microbiome's off and they have been using toxic things over the counter for the last 30, 40 years. And that's what's going on. And everybody that comes into me, I have to treat for sensitive skin, because even if I was to put them on a very active skin repair, their skin's going to react and they're going to say, oh, I couldn't use it because I was allergic to it. Why were you allergic to it? It's because your skin is so compromised. Your microbiome, just like our whole bodies, is so compromised. I mean, you might be allergic to almonds or something like that, and that's a given. But I need to correct the microbiome and the health of the skin before I can do anything with anybody. So I want you to think, I want to thank you for those of you that have followed me, and look forward. I know that I have my audience out there. I know that there's people out there that I even got one from Ireland. She is just a joy. She loves following my videos. But back to authenticity. I think one of the biggest things that I've learned too is I'm not gonna follow a script, and I'm not gonna over edit my videos. I watch some of these ones that they say about two sentences, and then it the camera goes away, and then they say another two sentences. That's too staged for me. So if I say something goofy, it's me, it's goofy. So, but anyway, thank you. I hope you have a wonderful day. We've got the holidays coming, and I've got lots to share. So if you like this and you haven't already, hit the thumbs up, the subscribe, and the bell, because I'm going to have quite a few new videos coming up. I got my new Ricky Loves Ricky camera that holds my, I'm still using my iPhone. And one of these days when I'm big enough, I'll buy a real camera. But anyway, thank you so much and enjoy your day.